Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. Do you want to experience macOS but don't want to buy a new computer? Or maybe you just want to try out some Mac apps without switching your whole setup? Well, you are in luck. Today I am going to show you how to install macOS on your Windows PC using VirtualBox. That's right, you can basically turn your Windows computer into a Mac. It's like having two computers in one. So, if you are curious about the Mac experience or just want to play around, this video is for you. Before you begin, I want to highlight that installing macOS on non-Apple hardware is technically against Apple's terms of service. This tutorial is for education purpose only. Use this information at your own risk. Also, make sure you have a legal copy of macOS. Before we begin, let's go over the prerequisites and preparation you will need. Disable memory integrity. Disable Hyper-V. Install Oracle VirtualBox. A Windows 11 computer with sufficient resources. A macOS Big Sur ISO file. One important note before you proceed. To run macOS on VirtualBox, you will need to disable a Windows security features called memory integrity, also known as code isolation, on your Windows 11 PC. These security features can interfere with virtualization, so you need to turn it off. Okay, so for that, you need to click on Windows search and type code. And from the suggestion, you have to select code isolation. And from here, you need to toggle the switch for memory integrity to the off position. Okay. Disabling memory integrity is necessary for the VirtualBox setup. And after that, you need to also disable Hyper-V to avoid conflict with VirtualBox. So the same way, for that, go to the start menu and this time you need to type Windows features. And from the suggestion, you have to select turn Windows features on or off. And here in the list of Windows features, uncheck Hyper-V. This also includes both Hyper-V management tools and Hyper-V platform. Okay, then click on OK. And follow any on-screen prompts to restart your PC if necessary. Once restarted, now let's create our virtual machine. So first, we need to download and install Oracle VirtualBox. So first, open your web browser and search for Download VirtualBox. And go to the VirtualBox websites. Here you can see the latest VirtualBox version 7.0.18 platform package. From here, download the latest version of Windows host. Okay, just click on this. It's nearly 104 MB size. So download can take few seconds depending on your internet speed. Okay. Once the download is complete, run the installer and you can follow the on-screen instruction to install VirtualBox on your computer. After that, close the VirtualBox. Now that we have our system prepared, the next step is to download the macOS ISO file. For that, open your web browser again and this time search for macOS ISO download. And from the search result, go to the archive.org websites. I have also given the link in the description below. Okay. And here in the right hand side, expand ISO image file. And it will give you the different version of macOS, you can see. And from the list, I will go for Big Sur. You need to click on this download link or button and it will start downloading the macOS Big Sur ISO file. And as you can see, it's around 13 GB file. So this may take some time depending on your internet speed. You have to wait until it finishes the downloading. Once the download is complete, you need to open your Oracle virtual machine. Here you need to click on New new icon at the top. Then you have to name this VirtualBox like macOS. So remember this name, okay? So this is the location where your virtual machine will be stored. If you want, you can change or you can leave the folder option as it is, okay? So in the ISO image, click on the drop down arrow and then click on others. Then locate the Big Sur images file we downloaded earlier and then click open. Set the type to macOS X and in the version to macOS X 64 bit. And then click on next. And in the hardware section, set the base memory, which is your RAM. You have to choose how much memory your virtual machine can consume. macOS needs at least 4 GB of RAM. If your computer allows, opt for the higher value to make your virtual machine faster. And in the number of processor cores, at least require 2 processor cores. The same way, if you have more, you can assign accordingly, okay? But remember, you should not allocate more than 50% of your PC resources to your virtual machine, else it will slow down your main PC, okay? And if you are not sure, right-click on the Windows icon, then click on Task Manager, then click on Performance, then click on Memory, and here you will find your total RAM capacity. For mine, it is 8 GB. Now that's why I'm assigning 4 GB of RAM, okay? And for the processor, click on CPU and here you will find cores. Once done, click on next. On the hard disk window, select create a virtual hard disk now and set a disk size of your macOS machine. At least 50 GB is required. You can set as per your disk space availability, okay? And after that, click on next. Then click on finish to apply the changes we have made. After that, you will see macOS is displaying in the left pane. That means you have created the virtual machine. So now let us make some configure in the settings to make it suitable for the macOS. To do the same, click on settings and from the left pane menu, you need to click on system. And here from the boot order, uncheck floppy box. And also you need to make sure that enable IO, APIC, enable hardware clock and enable EFI option has been checked. And after that, come to the display option. Now here you need to set the video memory increase to 128 MB. Okay, and check the enable 3D acceleration option if available. Now comes to the network options. And here in adapter 1, it's already been selected to default net. You can leave the default selected. Now click on the adapter 2 tab. On this tab, you will select a backup adapter in case the first is not available. Enable network adapter and from the drop down list, select bridged adapter. And then choose your Wi-Fi card from here. After that, click on USB menu option and then click the radio option next to USB 3 controller. Once done, finally click on OK. Now we need to run a few commands in command prompt to make macOS work smoothly on VirtualBox. So before doing the same, close the VirtualBox and make sure it's not running in the background. Now we need to click on the Windows Start menu. And here you need to type cmd. Then right click on the command prompt and click on run as administrator. Once the command prompt window will open, here you need to run few commands. So you can see these are the commands that I have already saved in my notepad. You have to run all those commands, okay? The commands I am using here, you will get those in the description below so that you can copy from there, okay? But before you run, you need to replace VM name with the name of your virtual machine that you have set earlier, okay? So here my virtual machine name is macOS that I have set earlier. So in order to replace it altogether, you need to select your virtual name, then go to edit, then click on find. Here click on the drop down arrow and in the replace box, you need to type your virtual box name. So in my case, it is macOS. Then click on replace all and you can see all the name has been replaced. Now you need to copy all those commands from here. So open the command prompt window, then right click and paste it, and it will run automatically. See, the first command will redirect you to the VirtualBox directory, and the rest of the code is there to make the virtual machine suitable for macOS. Once done, you need to close it. With everything set up, it's time to start the VM and install macOS Big Sur. For that, open VirtualBox and here select the macOS VM we created and click on the start button. And the macOS installer should boot and this start your new virtual machine. It may take several minutes for macOS to finish initializing. Okay, so especially the first time you launch the macOS. So wait for some time. When this page opens, select your language and click the arrow icon. And here you will have four options. You need to click on Dix Utility. Don't click on Install macOS Big Sur. Only click on Dix Utility. Then click on Continue. Here from the left pane, you need to select VBox Hard Disk Media. You need to format this virtual drive. Okay. So for that, click on Erase. Here, give the hard disk a name, something memorable, like I'm going to name it Big Sur HD. Then click on Erase again. Once completed, click on Done. Now you need to close this box. And this time you should click on Install macOS Big Sur. Then click on Continue. Again click Continue. Click on Agree to the Terms and Condition. And then agree again. The hard drive you just formatted should be listed at the bottom of the screen. Okay, so click on this hard disk and then click on continue to begin installing macOS. Okay, and this time it might take lots of time to initializing the macOS in your Windows PC. So to keep this video from getting too long, I'm going to bypass this portion, but you will have to wait until it's done. Okay. Once it is done, it will ask you to select your country or region. Choose your country and click on continue. Again click continue. And in the accessibility page, select not now. And in the migration assistant, you need to click on not now again. Then it will ask you to sign in with your Apple ID. If you have any, we can put it here. Otherwise, set up later and click on skip. In the terms and condition page, click on agree and again click on agree. Follow the remaining on-screen instruction to complete the installation. Congrats! You have successfully installed macOS Big Sur on Windows 11 using VirtualBox. Now you can explore the macOS environment and enjoy all the amazing Mac apps right on your Windows machine. Now additionally, if you want to make it full screen, then you need to adjust the resolution. Okay, so for that, close this VirtualBox, choose power of the machine. Once it's closed, click on the Windows Start menu and here you need to type cmd, right click on the command prompt and click run as administrator. Once the command prompt window will open, here you need to run few commands one by one. Okay, so these are the commands. Don't worry, I have already given this in the description below. So copy the first command and paste it here and press enter. Now you are in the VirtualBox location. Now you need to copy this remaining command and in the same way replace your virtual machine name before copying. Okay, and here you can see I am using 192.0.1.0.8.0, which is full HD resolution. If you want, you can change this resolution. Now copy this full command and in the command prompt page, right click and paste it and press the enter key on keyboard. After that, you need to close this window and again you need to open the VirtualBox. Once open, click on start. And you can see the resolution has been changed. And for the full screen, click on view and then click on full screen mode. Then click on switch. And there you have it. You have successfully installed macOS Big Sur in VirtualBox on Windows 11. So that's all for today. Thanks for joining me on this journey to set up a macOS Big Sur on VirtualBox. I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, please give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and hit the bell icon to stay updated with more tech tutorials. Thanks for watching.